Thank you all for making it with me. I, after leaving Adolphos Kayla's gravesite, I made a wrong turn, I made a wrong decision, ended up walking about a mile and a half, almost 2 miles around. I have not done that for years, probably. I am dead tired. And if I ain't careful, you're gonna take the cross that I made for him, his grave. You could put it on mine, because this is where I'm going to pass out. But that's okay. The Father was good to me. He made sure I had plenty of breezes, plenty of shade most of the way. What I want to do real quick is introduce this next film. I made it way back in 2009. Didn't know why. A lot of what you hear on it, Caleb tried to instruct. But he's not very good at teaching. He was still a beginner. When he was taken away from us. So, enjoy the video. I'm not going to talk much about it, because as I'm talking, I'm getting very lightheaded. But enjoy the video. I leave you this video number 5, the beginning of number 5. We've done 5 together since the beginning of this Master's Heartbeat program. Hope it's been some benefit to you. Others who've pre-watched this for me say it has. So I bid you peace from the Lord. Stay pure. Stay separated from the world. Our master's returning any time. So I bid you peace. In his name, amen. Glory to God. Morning, traveler. Morning, pilgrim. Old still, okay. I'm out here. We're just passing through some civilization on our way to the celestial city. Katie's out here with me this morning. We're hiking together on this segment of the trail, working on the introduction to this project we're currently working on called the Way Station, about how we as pilgrims on the way to see our King Jesus and those of us that are waiting his coronation as the true king of earth, give you an idea what's involved. And along the way we'll meet different travelers on the path, and we're at a new location. We've never been on this trail before with a camera, so we'll have different interviews for different people, and should be an interesting time. A new territory, new ground we've never traveled before, so I'm here to see what the Lord's going to show us, what people he's going to bring our way, what animals he's going to see, because we've got different animals on this one, so the stories passed down from other travelers have told us. We're getting ready to break out into a clearing as we change directions now, so enjoy. It's been raining here, but not nearly as bad as you saw on the last film we did. So thanks for your company, and we'll be sharing more with you as we travel this journey together today. We're out here now in the open. We've left the shelter of the trees, and if this were any later in the day, it'd be very difficult to walk, even be here. Let me pause for a minute and just look at the road where the ground we're walking on is just handfuls of rock on either side. Kate's been looking at the map just to see where we're at. There we go. She's my navigator with me on this segment of the trail. She's got wildlife as far as you could see. Off in the distance you can hear cranes calling to each other, crane families. Hear the crunch, hopefully, of our feet as we travel. If we were wearing sandals, or if we had lost our shoes due to some thief or robber, our feet would be all tore up from the rocks. Just like in our life, things take away our joy and leave us helpless and bloody, our feet hurting. so are these rocks. But we have Jesus and the Holy Spirit with us, and they keep us going. We're thankful of that. From some distance away, you can hear this water. Terrain still marshy, but what I enjoy about the spot, even though we're weary, is the sound of this water is refreshing to a soul. It's almost like having a good gentle breeze in your ear, how it makes you feel comfortable. Even though we can't see the Holy Spirit, he's with us, and he's soothing to our souls deep down. As a boy from Wyoming, the wind blows out there a lot, so I'm used to the wind, and when I don't hear it, I miss it. That's where the water's coming in at. It's a marshy area still. So even though we can't see the Holy Spirit, he's there. I find this water very comforting, the sound of it. We'll come up on an old foundation of an old building along the way to the Celestial City. Some people, for various reasons, have quit the trip and taken up roots. This is one of those such places. That's an old foundation, possibly an old homestead, maybe. Can't get too close. We just met with another traveler who maintains the road, and he was telling me they just put some spray to keep the weeds down. So we can't get out on the grass, but to give you an idea, this is just open land. Not a breath of air stirring out here. Whole idea of this is we don't want to take our roots. This is not our domain. We live in the heavenlies, even though our bodies are still here. Immediately after conversion, we're not immediately whisked away to heaven. We need to learn to grow, mature in the things of the faith, Bible reading and prayer. Fellowship with each other. I've got Kate with me. She's holding my stick. wave at the pretty camera. She's been my navigator around this trail with me today, keeping me company. So, glad you're still with me. And we'll record some more here as we get further down the road. We left the Highland area where we just came from. Where the people had taken root. We actually, I know it's not much of a, for you mountain folks, much of a drop. We've probably only dropped 6 or 8 feet within the last 50, 60 yards. Now we're now back down to the marshes. More wildlife galore. There's a family of marsh hens up ahead. I'm not gonna try to film today. Further up ahead, often on the horizon, are some family sandhill cranes. But God's glory is everywhere in his creation. From the trees, the open sky, there's scarcely a cloud in the area. We're back down on that gravel that cuts your feet. This beauty, we're on the final segment before we go back into the trees, and I think up by an old, worn out, rusted out windmill. We're gonna have some interviews coming up. Let's see if I can get. There we go. But thanks for being with me. We'll see you in just a little bit. My name's Captain CW. I've been your narrator, your host, your traveling companion for a while. We're going to stop and do an interview now at this point of the trail. Just
pause. How long have you been on the trail?
I've been saved just over 6 years.
now. So I've been traveling this trail actually before then. It took me a while to get saved. It took me a while before I realized I wasn't.
What has God taught you so far?
What I've been learning recently, that I'm 51 years old right now as we're filming this. And I first thought, great, I'm saved, I'm going to heaven. Let's get there. But God's allowed me to live these 6 years past the date of my true salvation. So the Christian life is not a hurry up and get to the end. It's day by day, moment by moment, breath by breath.
What Bible verse has been an encouragement to you as you struggle to live the Christian life?
1 Thessalonians 3:13, and I don't have it memorized. I only know bits and pieces, but I wrote it down. So I have cheat cards, which are upside down, so you can't read them. 1 Thessalonians 3:13 says, "To the end he may establish your hearts unblameable in holiness before God, even our Father, at the coming of the Lord Jesus Christ with all his saints." I know that Jesus is coming back for us, and I'm to live a pure and spotless life before the world so they can see God our Father.
What words of encouragement do you have for those who are behind you on the trail?
For those coming up from behind us, those that are getting saved now, or even maybe as we speak, there's some on the travel, some have started the journey with us. It's not a sprint. It'll take the rest of your life, but it is possible. The biggest tools I found are daily time spent with God and with Jesus in prayer, and reading His Word. They've become more recently what I get up in the morning to do. Without it, my day just doesn't go right. So those are my words. Stay close to Him. He'll keep you going. Holiness quest in recent months has become what I call my little company, if you want to call it, little ministry, where we take people out on such situations like this, where we're out away from civilization. Even though in this case we are close to civilization, you can hear cars and trucks and airplanes, and we just had one of the trail keepers come by, and we talked with earlier. One of the verses that I didn't get to share at the right spot helps keep me going is 1 John 2:17 and 28, and I read off my cheat cards. The world passes away, and the lust of the flesh thereof, but he that does the will of God abides forever. Verse 28 goes on to say, "And now, little children, abide in him, that when he shall appear, we may have confidence and not be ashamed before him at his coming." And that keeps me going, that also to know that when Jesus does come back, if I'm staying close to him, I'm not going to be ashamed.
We've just come from that direction, quite a ways away. The road ends up on the horizon. Now we've come up into a spot that is intriguing me ever since I first came over here. I'm going to turn the camera sideways so you can get a better view of it. Is a windmill, an old farmer's windmill. An old water tank, evidence of past civilizations. I'm going to walk now. Try to get around this mud puddle. It's been raining here. Not today. Today's been bright and sunny, hot. But yesterday was pretty, almost all day rain, slow soaking rain. Made the grass grow even more. Even though it's dreary, we still have the Spirit within us and our knowledge of Christ and His ways. That keeps us going during the dark times. That deep down goodness of Him that gets down and just stays put. It's another view of the windmill. I think a dragonfly just landed on my head. There's Kate like, "Oh yeah, there's a dragonfly on Daddy's head."
Actually, it's a butterfly, Dad.
It's a
really pretty one too. Thank you, Jesus, for creating it.
I've got a butterfly on my head.
Yeah, it's nice.
Okay, let's see if she can get a picture of it.
I'll turn you.
I don't know if you can see that close.
Yep. Are you on video?
No. Yeah, we're still on video.
Hello, people.
Okay, what's up?
Kate's going up ahead to check out the trail for me. She's been my navigator. Earlier, we gave away our map to some other pilgrims who had never gone this way yet. They were taking a different direction. They're not going to end up at the same place we will. There are people on this path who start at different times and locations, believing different things, and they don't end up in heaven. They end up in hell with the devil, the great deceiver. Scripture is loaded with Satan and him as a deceiver. Loaded full of descriptions, more than I want to get into right now at this part of the trail. We're coming up on some shade. The heat is just almost overwhelming. We're running low on water. Not here pretty soon. We'll get our water supply replenished, and it'll be a cool place to get a bath, get the rest, and get the trail dirt off of us. Now we're coming up almost an impassable water obstacle. How are we going to get around it? We'll see when we get there. So, it's been a good trip, especially having a little butterfly similar to a monarch. This one or two of them just fluttering around my head, and one of them actually took time to stay there for 30, 45, 50 seconds maybe. It's pretty neat. We're starting our final stretch of the leg of this first leg of the trip. We're now underneath trees on either side. Bushes are very close to the path. There's only one way. You cannot go left or right. You are going right down the middle of this path, such as God's word. He gives us clear directions, and it's up to us whether we follow them or not. If we get off the path and get in trouble, it's our own fault. It's not his. Also, this time of day, there's hunger in my belly. The food I ate earlier, several hours back, is gone. There's a pain. It's making noise. And unfortunately for you, you can't hear it on this film. I thought I heard thunder, but it was Katie's tummy, because she's hungry too. As she smacks me for saying, "No, Dad, that's not what you heard.
Don't lie,
I'm lying on camera. God's our witness. I'm messing with Kate more than anything." But Scripture says that as newborn babes, as desire the sincere milk of the Word of God. And Paul goes on that he would teach the Corinthians more, give them meat to eat instead of milk, but they can't handle it. They're immature. It's my desire as an author, as a teacher, as a fellow member of the Bride of Christ, that we dig deep into His Word. And don't be spoon-fed. Don't be bottle-fed by what other people give you. Dig in. Satisfy the hunger that's in your soul, that's in your belly. Get your own food for a change. And you'll find it tastes better. It's satisfies you more when you've actually done the work to get it. And then rely on the Holy Spirit to make it real to your life, for direction. I know you've heard me talk about the Holy Spirit. I'm not a Pentecostal. Don't even think that. But I am learning that Christ has given us the Holy Spirit, and it's up to Him to show us the things of Christ, because that's all He knows. He doesn't glorify Himself, but He glorifies Christ, mainly, also the Father. So rely upon that Spirit that lives within you as a follower of Christ. So He's there for a reason. Use Him for all He's worth. I mean, it's provided it's within keeping within God's Word. We're coming up onto another beautiful spot. And we're going to stop filming for just a minute. We're out here on a trail this morning. We've got Mary Nance in the blue, wife Susie's in the pink, and y'all know Katie. We're filming the last segment of this video. And only the Holy Spirit knows what's coming up. I've got some ideas. So relax, enjoy. Enjoy your time together as we get to know Mary better, and see what the Lord's done in her life, and we'll go from there. See you in the next clip. Already this morning, we've had some problems on the trail. We've got, I left my stick at a, up next to a tree while we took care of some physical needs. And when we came back, the stick I've had for probably 10, 15 years, somebody pilfered. So on the trail, we run into adversity with so much the conditions today, but with the people on the trail. Not everybody's going to heaven like we are. So just be cautious. Don't trust everybody that's on the trail. It could be working for the enemy to deceive you. We're at the Lost Bridge. Goes over swamp area. Over the years, enough pilgrims have passed through here. The locals who aren't going with us on our trek have built a bridge to go over the swamp area. It keeps our feet dry, helps us avoid having to get up to our waist deep in muck and water and all sorts of bugs and stuff that come along during the rainy season if you're caught out here. So we can praise God even for the unbelievers and their assistance and provide making our way a little bit easier. Maybe their torment in hell won't be as bad because they've helped the pilgrims. We've made it out of the swamp in one piece. No gator bites. I don't think any of the travelers have got even any mosquito bites.
Well, it's just sand here.
Hot as all get out in there. There's no breath. So from the swamp, we open up in this big open space. So we're going to talk, stop and take time, and we're going to have an interview with Mary Nance. We are right now stopped. We have Mary Nance. She's been on the trail for much longer than I have. And Mary, how long have you been saved?
Over 40 years, without giving my age away. Over 40 years!
What has God taught you so far?
God has taught me so far not to be anxious about anything, because I am naturally a worrier. And he has taught me that he's in control, he's in charge, and you can either believe that or not believe that, and I choose to believe that. And I just have to trust in him and believe on his promises and his truths, and he just takes me where he needs for me to go.
What Bible verse or verses have kept you going when times got tough?
My life verse is, "Be anxious for nothing, but in everything by prayer and supplication with thanksgiving, let your requests be made known to God, and the peace of God, which surpasses all understanding, will guard your hearts and minds through Christ Jesus." And that's found in Philippians 4, 6, and 7. It's just reassurance that I don't need to be anxious about anything, that God's, you know, in control, and I just need to give everything to him, and he'll lead me and guide me in the way that I need to go.
Do you have any words of encouragement for those who are just getting saved or coming up behind us on the trail?
Well, this April and May were very interesting months for me. And I saw firsthand things that people who are older than me would tell me. And so I want to tell the people who are younger than me that, yes, there is such a thing as empty nest. And there is such a thing as the sandwich generation, because in the course of 3 weeks, I married off my older daughter, moved my younger daughter into her first apartment at the University of Florida, and my mom broke her hip right after the wedding, and I saw my mom have to go into a nursing home and actually arrange for her to go into the nursing home for rehabilitation. And so I had to take care of my little ones, take care of my mom, get her all situated, and it was a very stressful time, but through it all, our family, we are laughers. We like to laugh a lot and have a lot of fun, and it's not really sarcasm, but it is sarcasm, but we just have this weird sense of humor that keeps us going, and the Lord has a wonderful sense of humor, because he brings the funniest things into our lives, and maybe we're just looking for them or whatever, but we pick out the weirdest and quirkiest and funniest things to laugh at, and know that the Lord sent that to us just, you know, to get our minds back on track, to trust in him, to love him, and to know that that yes, your children will grow up, that does happen, and your mothers will break their hips, and life is not perfect, and life, you know, even though you think as a Christian we've got this, you know, flu shot that we're inoculated from life, but we're not. And and life happens and stuff happens, and I know that the Lord puts things out there for you to follow the path that He wants you to go. But we as Christians, we as people, as humans, we don't want to do that, because sometimes that's hard. It takes us out of our lazy way of doing things to do things God's way. We don't want to do it that way. Our stubbornness and our hard-headedness comes in. And finally, when you just pray about it, turn it over to the Lord, He'll get you right back where you need to go in His will and go in His path. And I've just found that life is that way, that you that hard things come along, roadblocks come in the way that you think you need to be going. And if you will just submit and follow God's words and His will, life is so much easier and fulfilling.
Well, thank you, Mary. My daughter Kate, who's been with me on more than one of these quests out to the woods, is next on our list of people to be interviewed. From Katie, how long have you been saved?
I was saved on Mother's Day 2005, which is 4 years.
What has God taught you so far?
God has taught me to always trust in Him when times are tough and when I go astray and when the world gets the best of me.
What Bible verse or verses have kept you going when times have gotten tough for you?
Psalms 91, 9 through 12, and 14 through 16, because in these verses God promises protection. And they are, because you have made the Lord, who is my refuge, even the Most High, your dwelling place, no evil shall befall you, nor shall any plague come near your dwelling. For He shall give His angels charge over you, to keep you in all your ways. In His hand shall they bear you up, lest you dash your foot against a stone. Because He loves me, says the Lord, I will rescue Him, I will protect Him, for He acknowledges my name. He will call upon me, and I will answer Him. And I will be with him in trouble, and I will deliver him and honor him. With long life will I satisfy him and show him my salvation.
Do you have any words of encouragement for those who are just starting out or coming up behind you?
As a teenager, I think I've struggled the most with not being of this world and doing the thing God's want me to do and dealing with that. But other than that, it's really simple, like read, pray, trust, and know times are tough and everybody goes through bad times and things do happen. But if you read the Bible and you pray and you tell God all the things that you're worried about, and then He'll comfort you, and just trust in Him no matter what the situation is.
The Lord has sent some cooling breezes. We're out in the open now. It's nice to get away from the bugs, but something about that, this sunshine, it takes the energy out of you. But the Lord, in His kindness to His chosen ones, we'll send a cooling breeze to take the edge off the heat. So we're thankful for that, Lord Jesus. Thank you. Morning, travelers. We're out here we've had to retrace some of our steps to find some things we'd lost. Last night's storms that left us drenched to the bone have produced clear skies, cool air, cool, moist air. Right now I'm looking, and I can't zoom in with this camera, a family of cranes out in the bushes. There's downed trees, there's vegetation that's flattened because of the wind. Beautiful morning to be out walking. So thank you for joining me this morning. We'll be in touch here in this next clip. We all in our lives have times when God tells us to go a different direction than what we want to go as believers. And I can see why she doesn't want to go down. It's dark. It's deep. I mean, there's about a 6-foot drop off from where I'm standing now. There's water. There's bugs. Creepy crawlies. There's possibility of alligators on either side. I mean, not that they're on the trail or anything, but just those thoughts get you to willies. Kate's going to represent we as mankind, as the redeemed of the Lord, similar to what the prophet Jonah of old is doing. So Kate's going to represent man and his desire not to do what God has him to do, regardless of whether you know it's the right way or not. So this is what's going to happen next. You know, God wants you to come down this way with me. You gonna come or not?
No, why should I come down there? Like, seriously, what's down there? Like, gators and nasty and just, no.
Like, no, you coming down this way. God wants you to. He's not gonna give you any peace until you do.
Why should I? Like, seriously, I could go, I'll do my own thing, have my own life, live my own way.
But you know, if you go off this direction,
it's just going to get you in trouble.
Yeah, well, I like trouble sometimes. Bad things can do, but seriously, why should I stop? Why?
Well, go this way. It's because you love God and you're going to do, you want to do what He says to make you happy. To make you happy, because you know you have that in His best interest.
Seriously, how many times I've been hurt and just, no. Seriously,
okay, fine. Have it your way. Walk the direction you want to go.
Bye.
Stay put. Look at me. Thank you, Kate. Did a good job. This is her acting debut. The point is, when God tells us to do something, it's only because He wants the best for us. And He knows the end from the beginning. It's a matter of trust. I had the same problem. Go to Bible college at age 48 and follow Him or not and be miserable for the rest of my life, wondering what He had planned and what vision, what would have been realized had I done it His way. So I thank Kate for her help with this. We're on a new trail we've never been on. We're filming this on as fast as we can go. I've got other engagements to do today. So thank you. Thanks for being our companion on these series of three videos. This trailer we're just now getting ready to finish up. Not very long, if you don't mind spider webs every few feet, being surrounded by dragonflies. Saw our first butterfly, ancestor Naomi the butterfly from one of my stories. We're already out of breath. So I think we're nearing the end of our journey, though. Yep, it is. I see the road that leads to heaven. It's just right up the road. We can almost hear the heavenly chorus warming up for as they sing our entrance song into the kingdom. We stop. Take a look around as we leave this part of our existence. Is Kate still with me? So here we go. We're getting ready to bust out of this part of our lives and enter into a new and glorious way. A place we've dreamed of and talked about. And now it's almost here. Thank you, Jesus. This is where we just came from the entrance to this tunnel, if you want to call it a tunnel, as that's what it was like being in the trees. It's all shady, but now we're out in the open. It's a joy to be out in the breeze that the Lord has sent our way.
Nathan Sparrow, disciple of Jesus.
I'm going to a wedding. I'm going to a wedding. What's a wedding?
We're walking along, we're out of the, we've gone through the marshland, we've gone through the tree of decision, we made a decision now to follow Christ. We lived our life, now we're coming to the end of it. So what waits the believer at the end of their journey? And that is only of Christ in His kingdom, heaven. Up to now, we've only seen a reflection of the glory of heaven, the glory of Christ revealed through the Holy Spirit and revealed through the written, holy, inspired Word of God. But now we're at that point where Jesus is coming back. Even today could be the day that He comes back. So now, up to now, we've only seen the reflection of heaven. But on that day when Christ shall appear, we'll take and no longer see the reflection. We'll actually be able to look into His face in the glory of heaven. And all the saints of God will shout hallelujah to their King, the one and only risen Lord Jesus. So until that time, Lord Jesus,
keep us pure, unspotted from the world. By the mighty name, by your mighty name, the only name given to men in heaven and earth, thank you for that day. Amen and amen. We're closing in on the end of our journey here. You've just seen the wedding sequence as we prepare for the marriage supper of the Lamb, as in all good films. And I trust this is a good film. As the producer, director, main actor, I never know how they're going to end. We're closing in. We're tired. Katie's worn out, so am I. And I still have my paying job to go to here in another couple hours. But we do need an ending. We need to end this film. So this is what you're about to see is as I attempt to tie together all three films into one package. Thanks. Thank you for joining me. We're now at the end of this film. I want to recap everything we've been through in our journey together. We started out at the birth canal. You remember how we crossed that long bridge over at Kissimmee State Park on film one. And God allows us to be born in a particular time, place. Then we go from there. He gives us a chance to learn, to grow. He brings things, situations and people into our lives when that'll allow us to make a decision for him. Then along the way we run into again more situations. We trust him and we go to heaven. We don't trust him and go our own way. We go into hell in eternity without him. Film two, we are saved, we're going to heaven, we're excited, we're going our way. But adversity comes. You saw how we sludged through mile after mile, day after day, year after year, of just day to day. Sometimes it's a Christian life can be boring. Other times it's exciting. We have the mountaintop experiences where we see Christ coming. Maybe a thought of him coming up in the sun, like today I'm looking into the sun, just looks glorious through the trees. Now in this film called Way Station, we've, and it's hard to breathe because I'm tired. I'm at the end of my journey. My life is nearly over. I've reached the end of my life, and I'm looking backwards now at the way station. What has Christ taught me? What I want to emphasize with all my heart, these films have not been just to waste your time and resources to view these things, or to waste my time and effort and life making films just so nobody will get anything from them. What I want to emphasize with my whole soul is for those who don't know Christ. God says in his word, Romans 5:8, but God commended his love toward us in that while we were yet sinners, Christ died for us. But he goes on to say, Paul, in the book of Romans 6:23, for the wages of sin is death. He goes on to say, but the gift of God is eternal life through Jesus Christ our Lord. My heart's throb, my passion for you as an unbeliever, come to know Christ as I have, and as others have that you've met along the way in this film. Without him, your doom is sealed. Even before you get to hell, your doom is secured. So, come to know Christ as we have. Live a life pleasing to God, pure, unspotted before him, with the end result being you will go to heaven, you will experience his joy along the way. And that's about all I've got to say right now. Thank you for being with me. Thank you for being my traveling companion. I look forward to meeting you maybe someday in person here on Earth. If not, someday in heaven. Thank you again.